The rumors of my immediate superstardom had been greatly exaggerated, but not in a way one would think. I used to be anonymous, invisible. Everybody thought I didn't know anything about anyone. When kids would pass me in the hall, I would say hi, but they would only look around if they heard someone call their name from across the quad, and they'd walk right by. Sounds like a great story, right? Middle-aged teacher wondering, who am I? What's the point? Am I making a difference? Blah, blah, blah. But don't worry. This isn't one of those tales. This is about how I made myself famous. So, let the record show that I, Brad Denton, being of sound mind and below average muscle tone, swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. And what better way to share my private thoughts than to broadcast them on the school's new MacBook webcam? So here it is, part one, the true account of how I became the class of 2011's favorite teacher. The rumor is that people think that I became the best teacher of the year because of my teaching skills, my lesson plans, my seemingly unquenchable thirst for the prolonging of my students' lifelong learning abilities. But let me begin by saying there are two sides to every story. And mine, which is denying the rumor, is the right one. The fact is, I made myself teacher of the year. In order to begin explaining, I need to preface this explanation with some information regarding the class of 2011. This is the lunchroom, the place where everyone is equal but no one goes unclassified. Ah, yes, here we have the smart guys, the meatheads, the guys who go to every school sporting event, the jocks, not to be confused with the meatheads, the nice girls who win some kind of recognition every year, the girls who've been dreaming of Ivy League since their birth, and the girls who have not. As you can see, due to their stereotypical clique formation, the class of 2011 is, to be honest, easy to teach. So it's not like I won this award for creating innovative techniques or breaking learning barriers or teaching AP physics like Hamilton or really doing much teaching. Oh, and if you're wondering about the security camera thing, that brings me to part two. The easeability in which to install hidden cameras throughout campus. For example, let's take a look at my most recent installation.
Welcome, ladies, to your first tribal council. Let's get a little feedback about what's been happening this week. What has been the most trouble with adjusting to the outdoors?
Well, the outdoors isn't the trouble.
What is that supposed to mean?
Yeah, what's that supposed to mean?
Y'all are trying to sabotage everyone here and they're just too dumb to notice.
I don't even know what you're talking about.
Yeah, we don't know what you're talking about.
Typical, y'all are so full of it.
Katie isn't sabotaging anyone.
Oh, shoot.
Where did you even get that?
Don't worry about it.
Yeah, Aaron, prove it.
If y'all haven't noticed, there are cameras everywhere.
Yeah, Katie, they probably have footage somewhere around it.
Oh, ladies, okay, I'm sensing some animosity here. Anyone else? Stacy?
I will survive! I will survive!
Sorry I'm late, guys. I was taking care of business.
If you have any self-respect, you'll move it, okay?
How about you two, Megan, Madison?
We were told that there were going to be boys on this show, so where are they, Chandler?
Why is Rachel Turner calling me?
Wait, I thought this was The Bachelor.
Amateurs.
Excuse me?
I said you guys were a bunch of amateurs.
Amateurs?
Taylor, stop repeating everything that I say.
Sorry. I'm voting for Katie because she called me an amateur.
I'm voting for Chandler because there are no boys here.
I just really miss my boyfriend. Hi, Patrick, I miss you.
I'm voting for Katie because she didn't even tell me about this whole thing.
I'm voting for myself because, well, I didn't know who to vote for and I really don't like this drama.
I'm voting for me and Katie because we come as a package and if she goes, I go.
I'm voting for Erin because out of everyone, I hate her the most.
Well, I'm voting for Katie because I just don't like her.
Sorry, Katie.
First vote, Katie. Vote two, Katie. Third vote, Chandler. Who did this?
That's for lying to us about the boys.
Yeah, we want boys.
We want a new host. What about Matthew Stabell?
Okay. And the final vote is Katie.
Typical.
Katie, you got the last vote. You must leave at once.
I'm not leaving. That isn't fair. I'm going to stay and I'm going to win.
Security's outside.
I don't care about security.
Miss Wallaber is outside.
Fine, I'll leave, but this is not the last you'll see of me.
Well, at least the drama is over.
Well, almost. Katie!
Oh, I know. Yeah. I expected more. And you'd think that Survivor, really? The problem is, it gets even worse because we go from Survivor, which at least makes some kind of sense, to, well, I don't want to tell you. I want to show you. Take a look at this.
No, that is not how it's done.
I thought we went over this.
Tammy, let's show them how it's done.
All right.
It's time to.
Do you see what these people do? And I guess they think that people aren't watching. But the magic is now I am watching. And I get to blackmail them. Now, you may be thinking, Miss Miller, Miss Kenworthy, these are minor players in the grand scheme of things. But what would happen if you took, say, the most powerful person in the entire high school and you caught them on camera? By the way, really miss my homies in the social club.
I really would like to talk to you about more ways you can become involved here at GAC. And, you know, we have a lot of clubs on campus. One that you may not be aware of is our tattoo club. Well, you still going to go with the teardrop?
I'm going to go with the teardrop.
Okay. And you guys ready right now?
I'm ready.
Now, right now?
Yeah. Where'd you want to put it?
Back here.
That's a little painful.
That's all right.
All right, Alex, are you ready?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, here we go.
Was that a whiteboard? Was that a dry erase board? Was that Berland's back? Disgusting. Do you know what TMI means, Berland? But it got me what I needed, which is valuable blackmail information about Scott Harsh. Moving right along, you're probably wondering, if you're going for Teacher of the Year, who's your primary competition? Is it Crane Dog? Joe Rhodes? That guy whose name I can't remember that taught me Algebra 2? No, they let that guy go. But it's the young teachers. They're all between 16 and 19 years old. They've all got long hippie hair or short hippie hair. They're all really popular and they all look like kids. Yes, these people are my primary competition, but what's amazing is the Buftons, Dickersons, Wilson's, Isn's, Cost's, whatever the other one's name is of the world, these people also make mistakes, and they are videoed making mistakes. It's a beautiful world. It's a beautiful system. God bless America.
Did you watch
Warren
yesterday?
Yeah, dude, he went to jail.
No way.
Why?
I don't even know.
God.
Guys, can you please tuck your shirts in?
Okay.
Please?
No.
Like 180?
No.
Not gonna happen.
90 degrees?
No.
Yell at him, why don't you?
She has no clue what she's doing.
Yeah, let's go show her how. Watch this.
Hey! Tuck your shirt in.
Jeez.
Okay.
God, why you just pick on me?
It's gross. My head.
Back to pleading on me. Gotta get my followers.
How did y'all do that?
We'll show you later.
No worries.
Yep.
Okay.
Welcome to my hood. DJ Khaled, cash money, young money, we the best. Khaled, I'm welcome to you. My hood. We're a hood at. We're a hood at. We're a hood at. Welcome to my hood.
That was pathetic.
Can't even do nothing about them.
They're gonna need a miracle.
Let me stop us here for a second to answer the elephant in the room question, which is, what do these security cameras have to do with students voting me as Teacher of the Year? Actually, there's probably a bigger elephant in this room, and that's, what's making that guitar noise? Well, it's Connor.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't know you could hear that.
Totally cool. Before I answer the first of the elephant in the room questions, let me give you a few more examples, first, of what I can do.
Paula, I can't wait to go to Brazil this summer!
You know, it's gonna be great. I need to teach you a couple words, though.
Okay.
Gosto de ti.
Gosto de ti.
I like you.
I like you.
Tu é gato.
Tu é gato.
You're hot.
You're hot.
There's one more thing you should probably know.
Okay.
Me come.
Hi, Miss Joy.
Hey, Joy.
How are you? Why is she driving so fast?
Me come. What's that?
What?
I think we all saw that coming. Oh my goodness, that girl needs lessons. That's terrible. Was that a cake? Anyway.
Haley.
Yes?
I need you to go get these boys out of class for me.
All right, sure.
Thanks.
I can stand in line, but Hugh's
this phone call?
Yeah.
I have a note.
Who's it from?
Chad.
Why does everyone go to Chad? Go, good. Give it to him.
Okay.
Hey, Pat.
Hi, welcome to Chad's. We have robes and refreshments over there. Hi, welcome to Chad's. Would you like something to drink?
Oh, please, thank you.
Hey, welcome to Chad's. Would you like a robe?
I would, thank you.
Hi, welcome to Chad's. Would you like a robe?
Thank you, Misha.
Hey, welcome to Chad's. We have refreshments over there.
Thank you, Misha.
Hey, welcome to Chad's. We have refreshments over there.
Appreciate it.
And finally, the needed explanation of the connection between these cameras and my award brings me to the third and final part of this video. Namely, in order to be the best, an arsenal of blackmail is mandatory. You see, if you haven't figured it out by now, what I've been doing is systematically blackmailing each teacher you've seen in these videos. They had no choice but to enforce the nagging rules upon the class of 2011, thereby making themselves look terrible and making me look like the nicest person on campus. It's worked amazing! I've got dirt on every teacher that you've seen. Miss Runkle! Miss Wolliver! Coach Harsh! Miss Miller! Miss Kenworthy! All those young teachers whose names I can't really remember, but I think start with the letter... I'm really sorry, Connor. I just don't know all their names.
It's alright. We'll just keep going.
All those young teachers whose names I can't remember. And of course, Renee's driver's ed teacher. I have blackmail material on each and every one of these people. And I don't even want to tell you what I've got on Gary Crane. That's for a later video. But do you hear that? Is that a knock on? It's a knock on the door. Oh no, they know. Oh no, it's a result of me doing a live webcast. They know that I've taken over the closed circuit television system. But I'll tell you what, I'll never give it up. Never. I'm going to use this power forever. Not for good either. For furthering my own selfish ambitions. I'm going to become the principal, the president, the whatever Coach Burton does. I'm going to have all the power. I'm going to make Carolyn Maddox make me chocolate chip cookie cakes every day of the week. It's going to be amazing because I love this box. The power of the box will never die.